5. 1. Yeah. Makes it partly protective. 4, yeah, 5. It's 3. It's actually 5. It's on the 5 table. Plus 2 because the pugs are moving. Range of 2. 3. Minus 1. So 7 to 8. 7 to 8. 56. 1 step. Step around, there's one. This guy's a tie. 44, 1, 22. No effect. Okay, these guys. So these guys did that. Now we are going to return fire. Return fire is one thing we haven't done here, isn't it? The 6 and range of 2 is plus 1. And they're in prepared defensive position. They are in partly protective and they're dug in. So it's minus 4, minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, minus 4. These guys are gonna fire. Return fire. We got a 6. The reason why I'm talking to myself the entire time. I thought I had an SYR counter. Come on.
four, six, and three.
I guess I could have just said that, but whatever. You know what? Can't do that. Alright, I'm getting tired. I'm gonna pause this here. That's a bad shoot. I had to re-record this, so I'm gonna do this real quick. This is a morale check for these guys in which they passed, and a morale check for these guys in which they passed. However, the point shoots, point attacks from artillery, one tank dies, and then they fail their morale check. So this is a fail morale check here. And then we moved this tank up to here, and there's a line of sight from there to there. They fire, this guy fired, opportunity fire, and killed that tank. And we then got chicken and decided not to put any more guys up there because that's still quite powerful, even though it was partly protected there. And here, let's see, we tried to do a suppressing fire here, which had no effect. And I was just about to try and move up here, but I need to look up how we handle hedges. Whether that either A blocks line of sight or B, and B provides cover. I think it provides partially protected cover, but I'm not sure on the angles and all that sort of good stuff. So we're going to take a brief time out, and that's where we're at. And we're in the 1400 turn. The USA had passed.